Now we shall see a few orthopedic conditions. Rheumatoid arthritis. This is a typical hand of rheumatoid arthritis. Note the deformity of the small joints of the fingers. Whenever multiple joints are affected, especially small joints of fingers and toes, think of rheumatoid arthritis. Note the deformity of interphalangeal and metatarsophalangeal joints. In this patient, the wrists and the feet are also markedly affected. Rheumatoid arthritis is characterized by pain, swelling, and stiffness of multiple small joints, along with systemic features like anemia, weight loss, fever, and rheumatic nodules. Tetany. This is a typical position of fingers in tetany. The patient also gets severe cramps in the forearm muscles and hands. It is primarily due to calcium deficiency. So give intravenous calcium gluconate followed by oral calcium supplements. Note this swollen right knee. This particular boy was a hemophilic who has got hemarthrosis following a trivial injury. But normally, hemarthrosis may occur following an injury with a fracture or ligament tear, and you should ask for an X-ray. If this picture was seen with no history of trauma, but tenderness, warmth, and fever, then I would have suspected an acute pyogenic arthritis or rheumatic arthritis. And if the quadriceps, that is the thigh, was wasted and thin, I would have thought of tuberculous arthritis. In this patient, note the prominence of T10 vertebra. Tenderness and gibbous are typical of tuberculosis of spine. In a patient who has fallen from height, such a gibbous will indicate a compression fracture of the spine. If a patient with gibbous has weakness of legs, then he should be referred to an orthopedic surgeon urgently. This is kyphoscoliosis. Such extensive deformities are usually congenital. But if it is of recent onset or if it is increasing, then refer the patient to an orthopedic surgeon.